Hi, hello, how you going? My name's Ben, this is This Art, and today I'm here to discuss why bands like Bad Omens and Sleep Token are getting so huge. So by now I'm sure you've heard of the bands Bad Omens and Sleep Token, especially if you're into the heavy music or metalcore scene. Now a lot of people, myself included, have been wondering, why are these bands getting so popular? Now I personally think there's a multitude of reasons why these bands are getting so much success in the past 6 months. And today I'm going to go through a couple of my opinions on why. Now, before we go any further, I will preface this by saying all these thoughts and opinions as to why they're getting so successful is all my own personal opinion. Understand that these bands aren't for everybody. Even if you don't like them, you really can't deny that these bands are just blowing up in the space at the moment. But before we step any further, I'm going to make sure you go down, hit that like button, and subscribe. Now I'll go into specific detail about what each band is doing, but I will start this off by just giving a main statement as to why I think both of these bands are sort of doing what they're doing. Both bands in their own way have push the boundaries of what it means to be a heavy or metalcore band in the genre. What I mean by this is both bands have really experimented with blending the general metalcore or modern metal sound with their own personal, you know, style choices or genre choices, you know, from different areas of the, you know, the music industry. Now, these are definitely not the first bands to experiment with pushing the boundaries of metalcore, but I really think these two bands stand out as two groups that have, you know, really excelled and almost perfected it. Binding this with keeping out all the gatekeepers, you know who you are, they are really able to propel the metalcore and the heavy genre, you know, into the limelight again, which, to be honest, is what we need. Now let's get down to the nitty gritty. Like I mentioned before, both bands have done a really good job of blending the metalcore sound with their own personal genres. The band that's really done this well is Bad Omens, but blending metalcore with pop. Now I'm not talking about Britney or Pink or Beyonce or anyone like that. I've got one pop star in mind that they're really blending with, and that's Billie Eilish. You should see me in a crowd. I'm gonna run, there's nothing to help. I hear references to Billie Eilish's stuff through all of Bad Omens stuff, particularly on their latest record, The Death of Peace of Mind. Go through and randomly select any song on there, you're gonna hear all those sort of subtle sounds and synths that Billie uses, and they blend that with the metalcore sound so well. A prime example of a song off that record that does this is actually the title track, The Death of Peace of Mind. You're gonna keep it. Now, the song is 80%, you know, dark, gritty pop that Billie Eilish would do, with Noah singing this really nice sort of angelic and big vocal clean chords. But they also use a similar song structure to one of what Billie would use. It's not your general, you know, sort of intro, verse, chorus, outro that most pop stars would use. They do mix it up a little bit. Now, where the blending sort of comes into it for this song is, you know, you get well over halfway through the song and it's all been sort of pop and nice, dark, moody sound. But then you get punched in the face by this killer, you know, run-of-the-mill sort of metalcore breakdown. Another band that has experimented in this in the past couple of years and done it well is Bring the Horizon with their track, Ludens. You call this a connection? You call this a connection? Oh. Give me a break! Having this stark comparison in a song of sort of, you know, dark and moody pop sounds, they're getting smashed in the face by, you know, heavy guitars and breakdowns and chugs and growls, does two different things at the same time. First thing it does is for the people that are coming to listen to Bad Omens for, you know, metalcore and, you know, blast beats and breakdowns and drop tune riffs and everything like that, they get, you know, they listen to the song no matter what because they know the band has done that in the past. And they get, you know, through it and they go, oh, okay, it's poppy, it's a little bit moody, it's a little bit dark, it's not too bad. It's not like that really crystal clear pop. They get over halfway through the song and then they get what they're looking for. They get that really, really good taste of that breakdown that they were really, really searching for. And then when that finally hits, it's like a kid on Christmas morning. Now, why I think this works so well for, you know, the metalheads are coming to listen is Christmas is great and it's special and everybody loves it, but it would lose its specialness if it was every day of the year like that. So Bad Omens does a really good job of keeping those metalheads still coming back, but while experiencing a completely different sound and a completely different genre. And then comes in the pop people. They get pretty much 2.5 minutes of this lovely pop production. It's got those Billy sounds in there. It's got these really cool futuristic kind of sounding synths in there. It's got these lovely melodies that I was talking about before that Noah perfects really, really well. And, you know, they've got almost an entire song of that. And then, of course, like we were talking about before, the breakdown hits. And they go, oh, what's that? Now, obviously, that's not what they're going to the song for. They're coming to the song because of all that really nice pop, that Billie Eilish sound that Bad Omens does well. And then they're getting greeted with this breakdown. And they go, okay, right. It's cool because it still fits. It's not jarring. It's not like, hey, here's a, you know, a Britney song, but we're going to put a breakdown on it. It's not like pop goes punk or anything like that. It's a really smooth transition. So even though it hits them in the face, it still fits in really, really well. And then you'll find those people sort of diving into something they really haven't listened to before, which is breakdowns. What will happen to both sides, the metalheads and the popheads, is something that Bad Omens has thought up, and really, it's genius. The metalheads will go back to that song over and over again, just waiting for that breakdown hit. Because it's really a really solid breakdown. So they'll keep going back and back to that song to hear that breakdown. And then over time, when they keep on listening to the song, they'll actually go, hey, this pop isn't actually too bad. I actually really, really like it. It fits the mood, it amplifies the breakdown. I'm gonna go back to the rest of their songs and see what else is on the album that I might like. And then you've got the other side, the pop heads, which come in because they love the sound of it. It's pop, it's exactly what they want. It's that sort of modern, dark, poppy sound that, like I keep saying over and over again, Billie Eilish does really well. And then, you know, they keep hearing that breakdown and go, this is actually really cool. I actually really, really, really like this. And then they go listen to more Bad Omens stuff to go, okay, have they got any other songs which kind of do the same thing, which everything on that album does. And then they go listen to other metalcore bands. And that's where it's really, really good for the heavy scene and the metalcore genre, because it's bringing more ears and eyes to it from both sort of sides. Now, like I kind of said before, bands have done this, you know, time and time again, but I just don't think there's a band out there that's done such a seamless transition of it. The only other one I can think of is Bring Me the Horizon. But even then, some of their songs are pop and some of their songs are heavy. And every other band that's sort of done that, that I've heard, is pretty much the same. There's too stark of a comparison there. Bad Omens does, to me, a perfect job of blending those two genres together. And it is genius because, you know, both of these music groups, the pop heads and then the metal heads, are going to keep coming back to this music over and over again, and other heavy genres and other sort of dark poppy genres. And it's just pure genius. Hate and gatekeep all you like on Bad Omens, but the only thing that, you know, this does is wonders for our heavy scene. My next point, I think, is something that a lot of metalcore bands these days are practicing, but again, Bad Omens is kind of taking it to the next level, and that's look, imagery, and style. Now, like it or not, but if your band looks the part, they have a cool style about them, the name and logo is cool, but they follow it up on stage, you're gonna get more ears and eyes on you. Now, instead of going all in like Sleep Token does, which I will get to later, Bad Omens really backs this up and does the style imagery things with imagery and symbolism. Not only do they have a clean logo name, but they also have symbols above it, which if you actually pay close attention, actually stands for the Death of Peace of Mind. I've said it before and I will say it again, if your band has a cool symbol or a logo, I'm going to listen to them, I'm going to be attracted and go, what is that? What is this band doing? Another band that has done this well for years and years and years is 30 Seconds to Mars. Now, obviously, they've gone very much in the pop direction now, but it was definitely heavy and metal genre to begin with. They've really nailed this symbolic thing, you know, down pat. Their triad is the prime example of that. When I was growing up and, you know, my musical taste buds were, you know, developing and I was seeing what I liked, what I didn't like, it was the logo that got me at first. I was like, what is that? What is that symbol? What does that triangle mean? It's kind of eerie. It's just, I want to know more. And next, you go into the style of Bad Omens music videos. Every music video that they've released for the Death of Peace and Mind album just looks fantastic. It's got the right atmosphere, it's got the right style, it all has this sort of futuristic, dystopian sort of vibe to it, which matches with the music perfectly. Prime example of this is the film clip for the song Like a Villain. It's almost an exact replica of some of the famous scenes from the sci-fi movie Blade Runner 2049, which is personally one of my favourite movies of all time. It really wraps up that sort of dark future sound that I mentioned just before that the music has as well. Like, I listen to this song and I can almost imagine myself driving through Cyberpunk's Night City. Another great film clip for this is for their song The Grey. Every step forward, put a little more sword in your heart, yeah. Looking sideways when I say I'm okay with the past. Now, this is a simple film clip. It's literally just shot in this abandoned warehouse. It's just Noah singing along to it, projected on this big sheet here. Very, very simple, and you would think boring, but because of the vibe, because of the atmosphere of it, it just gives that essence of a dark future, a dystopian time. And all it does is elevate the music, which music videos are there for. Now, this is a big departure from the classic metalcore music videos of a girl standing in a field in a white dress, or people doing crabcore, you know, in a warehouse or in an industrial estate. By adding this, you know, intrigue and mystery with the atmosphere of their music videos and really just doing something completely different to what all metalcore bands have sort of done in the past, people just keep coming back for more and going, what's their next clip gonna be? What songs are going to be for, just has people wanting more. They also back this up phenomenally well on stage and at shows. Now, I recently went to a Bad Omens show. This is where I got the merch from, here in Brisbane. And the show starts, this intro music plays, Noah walks out first, and he comes out in this long coat that's buttoned up. He has a glove on one hand. I can't remember what hand it is. And it's like, oh, it's mysterious. He kind of looks like the antagonist for a film or a sci-fi film. He comes out, he starts singing, and then the band comes out one by one by one. Now, they play a few songs. Noah exits off the stage. The rest of the band stay on. And then Noah comes back out in a black Bad Omens robber's mask. And this is for their heaviest offering yet, which is Artificial Suicide. What this kind of symbolizes is it's almost like Noah's alter ego. He's coming out in this mask, and it's all screams, it's all growls in that song, and it just fits that sort of vibe. Once that song's finished, he goes back off, takes off the mask, takes off the jacket, and then they do the rest of the set. They create a complete stage show and story with their costume changes. This wraps up all their, you know, logo imagery, the atmosphere of their music videos, and the music itself with the shows into a nice, beautiful package. Bad Omens knows how to sell it. To close off the Bad Omens section, some would argue most of their success actually comes from TikTok. Now, if you haven't been paying attention to TikTok on the heavy scene, their song Just Pretend excelled on TikTok. I don't know what happened, but people were using it. Those videos were going viral, and it was just getting spread to, you know, millions of people. Now, of course, this is going to help their streaming numbers, but I don't think it really helps anything else. And the reason behind that is, you go on TikTok, you go on Reels, the people that live on those, you know, sort of two platforms, they only watch 15, 20 second videos. They're not gonna go sit through a 3.5 minute music video of a band, let alone go stand in line to go out to a gig and stand in a mosh pit for 2.5 hours. They just don't have the attention span for it. So I don't think it's really helping that much, the TikTok side. It's an easy argument that people bring up. We just need to blow up on TikTok and we'll be bad omens. But I really don't think it contributes that much. Yes, it's getting their streaming numbers, but they're not going to be selling merch. They're not going to be getting music video views. And most of all, they're not going to be getting those people out to gigs. Now onto the sleep token side of things. Sleep token are sort of on the other end of the genre. They still blend their, you know, heavy metalcore sounds and breakdowns with poppy elements, but those two genres that they do are a lot different to Bad Omens. And what I mean by that is their poppy sounds are more of a soulful, gospel-y sound. Almost sounds like the singer, you know, should be in church. And their metalcore sounds are a lot more prog-based and not using, you know, the stereotypical metal structure. You can hear this in pretty much 99% of their songs. Now, although in my opinion, Sleep Token doesn't do as good of a job as blending those two genres together as Bad Omens, they still excel at selling themselves, selling the product in other, you know, sort of means. The obvious one here is imagery and lore. Now, Sleep Token have taken the idea of what bands like Slipknot and Ghost have done, where they all wear masks and they have somewhat secret identities, but they've just taken it to a completely different level. If you haven't looked into Sleep Token or heard of them much, I'll go over sort of what their lore and their story is. Now, Sleep Token is a group of people that worship an ancient deity called Sleep. Now, the members of the group don't have a name. They all go by the name Vessel. The singer being, you know, just Vessel, and then, you know, the bass player and guitarist, drummer being Vessel 2, 3, and 4. And basically, as the name sort of, you know, gives a hint to, they are the vessels to speak the word of Sleep. From this description alone, you are probably already hooked like I was. Further expand on the sort of imagery and lore behind Sleep Token, they do the same thing that Bad Omens does well, and that's have, you know, a clean name logo, but then their symbols are just phenomenal. They're almost culty. They also back it up with really, really atmospheric music videos to amplify the music. Now, the music videos, although atmospheric and fit the music, are very, very different to Bad Omens ones. Bad Omens is the sort of dark, futuristic, cyberpunk-y feel, and Sleep Token sort of have a, you know, dark forest, Nordic god sort of vibe to them. Reminds me a lot of the movie called The Ritual, if you haven't seen it. They also back this up with their songwriting. All the synths and the vocals and the guitars have that sort of dark forest vibe to it. You can hear that perfectly on a song like The Summoning. And the band is also extremely talented. The singer is one of the cool, most unique singers I've heard in the metal genre in a long time. And, you know, the bass player and the guitarist, also phenomenal. A big standout is the drummer. If you go to a show or watch any live clips of them, really pay attention to the drummer because he is just phenomenal. Now, obviously, all these sort of points tie into each other and it's something both the bands are doing. But it should be a pretty good example of what to do as a metalcore band if you're wanting to propel yourself the same way that Sleep Token, Bad Omens has done. As I said before, love or hate these bands, but there's something you can't deny. They're just getting stupidly popular in the past 6 months, and like I said, it just does wonders for the metal genre. Now that pretty much wraps this video up. I hope it was informative, and I hope it makes you want to go out there and listen to these bands if you have not, and give them a chance, because they really are doing wonders for our heavy scene. Now, if you liked this video, give it a like. If you loved it, subscribe. If you didn't, just roll it back, give it another chance. My name's Ben, this is This Art, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.